to closing remarks. Again, there will be 3 minutes for each candidate, and we'll be going in reverse order of the opening remarks. So we'll be 4, 3, 2, 1. So starting with Louis Brown, I'll invite you forward for your closing remarks.
Thanks very much, ladies and gentlemen. This takes us to the concluding part of our evening. I certainly want to thank my fellow candidates who attended this evening. I want to thank all of you and our moderator and our timekeeper. We are pledging the largest infrastructure investment in the Canada's history, as I said before. We want to get program delivery happening immediately. Justin Trudeau has been very honest and frank with Canadians about how we're going to do that. We are going to run some small deficits for a couple of years, and then we're going to get back to balance, just like we did in the 1990s, the last time we inherited and fixed a conservative mess. And we will do it again with your support starting in October of this year. Now, because our leader has been frank and honest about that, we are taking it on the chin, and we're prepared to take it on the chin from our right-wing opponents and right-wing opponents. Now, mind you, tonight, my chin's doing rather well. I didn't have a conservative opponent to throw any curveballs at me. But nonetheless, the most heated Twitter exchange I've been in so far was with the president of the Canadian Taxpayers Federation about that. So we're being honest about it. We're going to make a massive investment in infrastructure, transit, social infrastructure, green infrastructure. As well, we're standing up for the middle class and all those working hard to join it. Our tax cut, as I said earlier, we will cut the taxes of all Canadians who earn between $44,000 to about $215,000. We're going to raise the taxes on the super rich to balance that off. Our Canada Child Benefit will give more money to 9 out of 10 Canadian families than under Mr. Harper's current plan. One of the ways that we're going to do that, we're going to stop sending money to millionaires and redirect it to the families who need it the most. Under our Canada Child Benefit, 315,000 Canadian children will be lifted out of poverty. Additionally, we've committed $150 million new dollars for CBC and Radio Canada. We strongly support it. Thank you very much. We strongly support our public broadcaster, as it's evidenced by our funding commitment to it. We also want to double the investment for the Canada Council for the Arts to $360 million from the current $180 million allocation. And as one of your former board members at the Mackenzie Art Gallery for 6 years, that's something that I strongly support as well. I was also in the City Council. Thank you very much. Also the City Council Liaison Committee for the Arts Advisory Committee at City Hall for several years. So when it comes down to standing up for the middle class and all those working hard to join it, you can count on the Liberal Party of Canada to do so. Additionally, it's one of the things that Mr. Harper's moral compass has just really dramatically malfunctioned with respect to our veterans. I don't understand that. As a former reservist myself, I strongly support our veterans. We should be taking care of these very men and women who are prepared to put their life on the line for us. Thank you so very much. Merci beaucoup.
Well, thanks so much. I really appreciate the organizers putting this event together. I really appreciate everyone giving up an evening to come here and check it out. I really appreciate all the excellent questions. We've covered some really good topics tonight, but there's actually one that I was kind of expecting from this crowd that we didn't get to, and that was Bill C-51. I'm really proud to be running for the NDP, which led the opposition to this totally unnecessary and overreaching surveillance law. I kind of wish it had come up, because it would have provided a rare and glorious moment of agreement between the NDP and the Libertarians, but... In any case, I do really think that that's an important point of distinction between us on the one hand and the Liberals and the Conservatives who voted for that bill on the other hand. But overall, what I found tonight was that there were a lot of agreement on the main issues. There was actually a lot of consensus on this stage. You heard a lot of the candidates, I think, making some pretty similar points. And I think that most Canadians actually do want to achieve a change of government. And the question before us, the question that you'll have to ask yourself in the voting booth in just under 3 weeks from now, is how best to achieve that change. And I suppose I would remind everyone that in the last federal election, the Conservatives won almost every riding in Saskatchewan, and in every single riding that they won, the NDP came second. So if you want to achieve a change of government, if you want to replace Stephen Harper, the only way to do that in our first-past-the-post system is to vote NDP. And I wish I didn't have to make this argument, because we should have a system of proportional representation where people could just vote based on what they believe. The NDP is committed to bring that into place, but we have to fight this election under a first-past-the-post system. And it's a particularly stark choice in Regina Louvain, where all the candidates in this stage are running. Elections Canada reports that if these new boundaries had existed in the last federal election, the vote within them would have been 45% NDP to 44% Conservative, all the way down to 8% Liberal, 3% Green. So I'm in a really tight race against the Conservative candidate who didn't show up tonight, and I would really appreciate your support in defeating him so that we can have a non-Conservative MP on the western part of Regina. Some other evidence that came out, we had this poll on the front page of the Leader Post a few days ago. It suggests that the Conservatives were a little bit ahead of the NDP, but again, it confirmed that what we're dealing with in Regina Louvain, as in most Saskatchewan ridings, is a two-way fight between the NDP and the Conservatives. So I certainly appreciate all the different parties and perspectives, but I would really make the appeal that if you want to change the government, if you want to get Stephen Harper out of there, please vote NDP. Thanks very much.
Surveillance and phone line surveillance. We lost some civic rights on the pretense of protecting our from terrorists and from being getting security for our. We have to pay with our rights for security. Now the other thing is we should restore the democracy, which I mean that right now our system evolves into something that is partitocracy. The parties actually rule, not the MPs. The MPs cannot vote their conscience in the parliament. So what I propose that the MPs have autonomy. The way it is, Samara Canada is one organization who proposes reforms to our system that would empower MPs to voice the concerns of their constituents and their conscience. The other point, now the proportional representation may not solve it. Proportional representation would make the district much larger, where the contact between the MP and the electorate will be diminished actually. So I would prefer not going this route. Now as for the other important thing is our fiscal responsibility. Our country is running more and more into debt. The 8 years the current government never could balance the budget. They promise right now, actually all of the parties promise that hopefully this will happen. Otherwise we will go bankrupt. We are paying too much already in servicing the debt, and we are in danger of heading towards austerity, which will not benefit anybody. Part of this trouble of imbalanced budget are bailouts of failing companies or failing industries and corporate welfare. This is immoral that the tax money from middle class is being transferred for those who own the big corporations or big banks. It is simply not fair that it is happening. When we bail out for billions of dollars, then the treasury is empty. And the next step that government does, well, we don't have any money for basic infrastructure, we don't have money for healthcare, for education. This is what the taxes are collected for. They were not collected to give so for some multinationals that basically have bigger power to lobby government for handouts. The bailouts are also bad, and it favors obsolete industry. if a horse-drawn carriage won't bail out, they would get the bailout rather than supporting modern cars or planes and so on. So, my time is up. Thank you.
For organizing this and for hosting. Thank you for coming out. Thank you, candidate colleagues, for your presentations. I want you to think about some of the greatest leaders in history for a bit. Martin Luther King Jr., Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela. How many of them stood up before the people and said, be afraid, be very, very afraid. We have, and we have largely bought into it, we have been invited as a population into a politics of fear. We gotta stop Harper. Justin's just not ready. The NDP, well, they're gonna tank the economy. And the Greens, well, we love the Greens. We love Elizabeth May. Too bad they just don't have a chance. You know what? That's all bull. Every single one of those, pardon me, that's all bull. The Greens do have a chance. I'm inviting you, Elizabeth May is inviting the Canadian population to a politics of courage, a politics of getting to know our neighbors, of empathy, of action. And of course we can do this. If Regina Louvin or any of the other ridings in Regina, if any riding in Canada wants a Green candidate or a Libertarian candidate, we can put those people in office. Here's the numbers. With what would have been Regina Louvin last election, 23,000 people did not show up. They voted for none of the above. The person who would have won would have needed 15,545 votes. So maybe we should have sent none of the above to Ottawa, because that's apparently what most of our neighbors want. That's not what I want. That's not what I want. I want to go and I want to represent my neighbors. And here's the other flaw in our democracy right now, the foundational issue. The NDP, 100% of votes whipped. The Liberals, 90% votes whipped. The Conservatives, 76% votes whipped. So it really doesn't matter what the constituents say, it matters what the party leaders say. The Greens, no votes whipped. I can vote for my constituents. So you want to know how to make this happen? Each one, if you... I hear this, when we talk to Liberals and NDPs and Conservatives even at the door, they say, we love Elizabeth May. We like what she has to say. You're our solid second choice. Or if they're Green lovers, it's like, I'm afraid of Harper getting in. You know what? Harper's not the problem. He is the result of the problem. The problem is first past the post. The problem is too much power in the Prime Minister's office. We have to divest it. Here's the short answer on the math. Each one, reach one, five times we win. We can do it, it works.
Thank you. Again, your candidate participants for this evening have been Tamala Friesen for the Green Party, Wojciech Dłuża for the Libertarian Party, Aaron Weir for the New Democratic Party, and Louis Brown for the Liberal Party. I would like to thank them all for taking part and for doing so well in adhering to the time constraints. We can tell you've been all had lots of practice. I'm now going to invite Kathy Gibson to close the formal part of the evening with a few words on behalf of the Community Coalition for Planning Committee.
I'm doing it without notes. First of all, I think we should all give a really great hand to Patricia. She is the absolute best moderator I have ever come across. Just excellent. And I'd like to add Pat Trisha's comments to the candidates. I think you're all awesome. in working on this program, I've really come to appreciate what it might be like to decide that you're going to run for office. I admire that you're putting your hat in the ring, that you're sticking your neck out, and your chin, and any other body part. And I know that your friends and family have to sacrifice a lot because there's just so many demands upon you, and I thank you very, very much. In fact, I was thinking, the quality of people we have here, I can't understand why our government is so bad. But wait. We need to give a really special thanks to Knox Metropolitan Church, United Church, because they are so generous with their building, and they made it possible for us to put this on because we were a group, sort of a ragtag group. We have no money, no phone number, no office. We just got together and met. So I invite you to go back downstairs. We have the building for a little bit longer and talk with people, help us clean up if you feel that way, and you know, just go home and think about all you heard tonight. I know I learned a thing or two. How about the rest of you? When you get downstairs, go talk to Jim. He's the one with the beard. He said something about a website and a posting and what have you. So he'll explain it better than I ever could, because I don't do websites. Again, thank you so much for coming.